Scheduling summaries is one of the most common uses of the messaging and schedule task utility. Because of the nature of summaries, that they're not the most interactive on the screen with your users, and also because of that they are usually taking a large amount of data and creating a subset of that data, it's typically recommended to run these summaries in the background so that they're not utilizing valuable resources during high activity times of Empower usage. So scheduling those summaries is a great way to utilize this template. So in my demonstration, what I'll be doing is that I have a monthly order report that I'd like to be emailed out at the beginning of every month that summarizes and gives me data from the previous month and then compares that to the previous so many months as well. So I have two applications that I've already created. One is going to be a summary that again takes everything that I have. It takes my orders history table and it will summarize everything to the month and then just add that previous month to my table. And then I have a report that's been created and I will be sending that report out to just a static email with this. So again, I've already had my summary created, and quickly I'll show you the report that I have created as well. So here we're looking at the report as it stands. Currently, the last month that it was ran was January of 2016. It is currently March right now. So the idea is that when this summary runs, it's going to find all of the records for February, summarize them into one record, and then add it to this table for February of 2016. And then it will email this report, an updated report, out to me. So let's go back to the utility here, and we're going to create a new task. We actually will need two tasks for our task group here. One will be the summary that is going to run first. When the summary is finished, we're going to have the task as the report that's going to send us out that report. So I'm going to create a new task group called the monthly orders report. And on my first task that I'm going to use as my description will just be my summary. Now, sequencing is important here because I do need to have that summary ran before the report goes out. So I'm going to call this a sequence number one, and then I will choose my run a summary message type. The target application is going to be very simple here with the summary. I'm going to choose my dictionary where my summary lives, and then I'll actually choose the summary that I have in place. The additional parameters field is going to be for any additional parameters you want to include in the URL for this summary. Anything that's going to filter your records or control the behavior that you want to add, you have that ability to come into the additional parameters and add that in there. So the last thing is to look at the review of this task and make sure that everything is in place. So once we come back to the main menu of our messaging task groups here, I'm going to add a new task to create the report task to our monthly orders report. So I'll click the plus icon to add a task. You see that the monthly orders report task group has already been selected, and now I can name this task as just my report. And again, the sequence number needs to be after the summary, the last task that I created, so I'll use sequence number as 2. And I'm just going to use a regular email a report message type. Under this tab here, I'm going to be skipping over a lot of these options because I just need a very simple report that's going to be emailed out to a static email. So I'll be skipping over a lot of these options. If you do want to see these options and have explanations for these options, we do have documentation and other videos in this video series that will go through every single one of these. So I encourage you to take a look at the links or the notes section below, which will point out that link there. So my report is going to be in my task test dictionary. I'll choose my monthly orders report. I don't need any additional parameters. Map fields to report is just if you're triggering this task from a maintainer, which I am not doing, so I'm going to skip that as well. I am going to send this as an attachment and not embed the message in the body. And the output format that I'm going to choose will just be a PDF that we'll create. So my file name that I'm going to choose is going to be monthly orders, but I want to also include the date for this so that I know in my file name that it's being created, my PDF, that I know what date and what this pertains to. So I'm going to use just the hard-coded variable of date stamp, which is going to just include the current date that this task is ran for. with your file name, it's very important to include the file extension in this as well, or else the task will not run. So very important to remember the file name. The Recipients tab is going to allow me to choose where I want to send that report to. So the first options here for recipients per message, send one report for all recipients means that the report is going to run one time, send the report out for every recipient that's in a list, whether that's a distribution list or hard-coded in the additional addresses box here. The second option is to send one report per recipients, which means that every recipient that's in my list, again, from a distribution list or hard-coded, the report will run one time and then email it out to the first recipient. Then the report will run a second time separately and email that out to the second recipient separately. And then it will continue to do that until all recipients have received an email. The last option is only going to be used if you're calling this task from a maintainer. You can map the field from the maintainer to your task here. So I'm going to choose the very first one to just send one report for all recipients. If you choose to use a distribution list, you can use this option here to select an application to retrieve your addresses. Again, for my demonstration right here, I'm not going to be using this. What I am going to do is hard code my email so that I can just receive the one email report that we needed to send out. The next tab is the email info. Sender, being the first option here, is going to pull from the configuration file and will appear on your email as the from email address. If you leave this option blank here, it will pull from that configuration, but you do have the option to override that with this option here. Message subject is going to be the subject line for your email as it goes out. So I'll go ahead and include my monthly orders report here. And I'm also going to include that same date stamp variable so that I know the date that this was sent out for. The message is going to be any hard-coded text you want to include in there. And then attachments is going to be any static attachments you want to include in your email. These are going to be stored and live on the server, the MPower server, under the MRC Java Job Streams Attachments folder. And then lastly, as all task groups, you can review your task as it stands here. So now that we're back at our main menu for the task groups, we can see our task group has been created for the monthly orders report. We can see that the summary is the first sequence of our task group, and then the second task is the report that will be emailed out. So what we're going to need to do now is actually schedule this report. So we're going to come to our messaging menu dropdown, and under scheduled tasks, right now I have no tasks scheduled, so I will create a new scheduled task. And under the scheduled type, you can either schedule task groups as what we want to do here, or there's also business rules that you can schedule as well. But for our purposes, again, we're going to use the task group, and I'm going to use the task group for my monthly orders report. And then the frequency is where we're going to set how often do you want to schedule this to be ran. Again, for this real world purposes right now, I would want to schedule this every month on the first, and then I could set the time. If I want this to run at 2 o'clock in the morning, I could set this in here, and this is how this would run. But for demonstration purposes, since we don't have to wait until the first to schedule this or to run this, I'm just going to run this every minute. Any changes to the scheduled task, any new ones or any modified tasks, scheduled tasks that are made, you do need to reload Tomcat in order for that to take place. So we'll click that and reload it directly from the interface. It is saved. So now we can wait and for our email to come through. And here's our email. So we have the subject line here, as I said before, and then also you notice that the date has been replaced as the date stamp. And then when I open my report, now we can see that where before the last entry was the January of 2016, now we have the summarized record for February of 2016. So this is all a scheduled task that we've created here. You can schedule this to go out on the first of the month, and it will run that summary for you and send the email out for that report or any other task that you have that you want to send out. So that is how you would schedule a summary and send a report out via email afterwards. Thanks for watching and have a great one.